Hey guys, welcome to Cool Bits, where we point out our favorite small moments from popular and maybe not so popular games. These cool bits might be a secret, an Easter egg, or just a small detail that really resonated with us. This time, we'll be taking a look at a few surprising details in Blast Corps for the Nintendo 64. Now, I probably don't need to tell you that video games aren't typically known for their scientific accuracy, and Blast Corps is no exception. After all, it's a game based entirely around destroying things in order to clear a path for a truck stuck in autopilot that's carrying a pair of nuclear missiles, which apparently are so unstable they'll detonate even so much as brush up against them. Yeah, it's pretty out there, and it still gets even sillier. Now, if you've played the game before, then you've probably noticed various celestial bodies orbiting the sun in the background of the map screen. But they're not just for show, because if you stick with the game to the end, you'll be able to catch a ride on a space shuttle and actually visit them, which includes the moon and the planets Mercury, Venus, Mars, and Neptune. It's pretty wild, and they're fun to play around in due to the varying amounts of gravity, even if the gravity levels aren't entirely accurate. Take Neptune for example, which should actually feature the highest amount of gravity in the bunch instead of the lowest. Wait a second. How are we even driving on Neptune? The entire planet's supposed to be made of gas. There really shouldn't be any solid surfaces anywhere. But at least the developers got the planet's blue color right. So clearly Blast Corps doesn't give a shit about scientific accuracy. But is that really the case? To find out, let's try taking a look at the map screen again from the perspective of Earth. If we keep an eye on the sun, we can see that it takes the Earth exactly 1 minute to fully orbit around it, which of course represents a full year in real life. And speaking of real life, in that same time span, the moon would have orbited the Earth about 13 times. And if we fast forward the footage here, we can see that the moon does in fact orbit the Earth that exact amount of times during the 1 minute cycle. So that's pretty nifty. So far, the Earth and the moon both appear to orbit the sun just as they would in real life, except much faster, of course. But does that principle extend to the planets in the background? Let's find out. To Mercury, and beyond. So in real life, it should take Mercury 88 Earth days to orbit the sun. But since we're dealing with a fast-paced Blast Corps universe, it should only take 14 seconds or so, using the Earth's 1 minute orbit as reference. Which means we should be seeing the sun again in 3, 2, 1... Oh, there it is, right on time. Same goes for Venus. In real life, it takes 225 Earth days to complete its orbit, which comes out to 37 seconds in Blast Corps time. And of course, we timed it, that's exactly how long it ends up taking. And as you might have guessed, that goes for Mars too. In real life, its orbit would take 687 Earth days, but in Blast Corps time, that would only be 1 minute 53 seconds, which again is precisely what ends up happening. So far, so good. But let's take a look at the game's final planet, Neptune. As you might have noticed yourself, there doesn't appear to be anything going on in the background besides the stars. That means no planets and no sun. But if you can hang on for just about an hour, you'll finally see the sun and the other planets slowly swing into view. And that's because Neptune has an incredibly long orbit compared to the other planets. It takes 165 Earth years for it to go around the sun just once. Yeah, you heard right, 165 years. Which means that, even in accelerated Blast Corps time, that's a really long time. 2 hours and 45 minutes long to be precise, which as you probably guessed, is exactly how long it'll take if you want to watch the entire orbit from this point. Pretty crazy, huh? In fact, the planet's orbits are so accurate that it even recreates a real-life phenomenon called apparent retrograde motion. Okay, I can already hear some of you asking, what? Let me explain. Have you ever noticed that some of the planets in the background here appear to occasionally move backwards? Well, the same thing happens in real life, too. Of course, the planets aren't actually switching directions since orbits are a one-way street. But it can look that way when the planet you're on, Earth in this case, overtakes another planet farther out with a longer orbit, causing it to appear as if it's moving in reverse. And Blast Corps actually makes this nifty illusion far easier to see than it would be in real life. Pretty cool, huh? Who would have thought that a game where you use giant robots to destroy buildings would pay so much attention to astronomically small details that pretty much only geeks would catch? You could almost use the game to teach an astronomy lesson. Admittedly a short one, but still, that's pretty damn impressive for an action game. And that wraps up this episode of Cool Bits for Blast Corps. Now let us know if you have any cool bits of your own by posting in the comments, and we may feature it in a future episode. Thanks for watching, and make sure to stay tuned to GameExplained.com for more cool bits and everything gaming.